Greetings, DanetteChavis here. Just sharing a little information with you all on the HR 40 bill, mainly for my page, Cut the Check, which we stand in support of reparations for the descendants of Africans enslaved here in America. But I hope the information will be beneficial for anybody who's concerned with reparations that are owed and due. I'm doing this video because we just finished having a little bit of discussion on my page, and some people are new to the page and not quite sure what reparations are or not quite sure about the HR 40 bill, what this most recent discussion is that's been held concerning it. And the reason is because a discussion and a vote was held yesterday in a judicial committee in Washington to see whether the bill, the HR 40 bill, would be given a vote to allow it to proceed forward so that it could be passed. The bill was passed, and this is historic, not because it means that we now have reparations coming towards us. It's historic because that bill literally sat up there for 30 years, over 30 years maybe, without even so much as a discussion. They didn't even want to entertain a conversation as to whether or not Blacks in this country should be given the reparations that are owed and due. But now that discussion has been held and a vote has been given and the bill has been voted on to move forward. It can now move forward into becoming law. When it becomes a law, it requires the establishing of a commission, not just for the study of slavery, but the end result is supposed to be reparations, ways by which reparations could finally be received by those to whom it is due. It's not enough just to say, you enslaved our ancestors and today we're still suffering underneath the wreckage of slavery. You need a commission which will formally outline all the ways in which our ancestors suffered and the ways in which we suffer today. Whether it's Jim Crow laws, red zoning, financial discrepancies, discrimination, all of it, whatever means that they can describe or outline and say Blacks suffered as a result of slavery due to A, B, C, and D, then reparations ought to be made concerning A, B, C, and D to come up with a make whole remedy, not just to pay us what's owed and due for that suffering, but the remedy should be so that they never occur again. Okay, it's not just giving money or giving land or giving institution or whatever is being proposed. It's supposed to be a make whole remedy. And that means that measures are taken so that the discrimination and the racism no longer exists. That's a big fat requests, but right now we are dealing with pay us what you owe. Okay, that's what we're dealing with right now. You know, there's a lot of other things that need to be answered as far as who are those Blacks in America who's entitled to reparation. But I mean, can we at least get a law passed first? Because some of y'all are jumping the gun, you know, and I'm not saying that these are not things that may need to be dealt with somewhere down the line, but can we at least get passed through this HR 40 bill? Because without no bill, there's no conversation on reparations. None that I heard of, none that is nationwide, none that has caused the people in Washington who are going to be responsible for distributing reparations to stand up and hold attention. You have every right and will and withal to organize yourself and come up with a nationwide demand that this country pay us what is owed and due. You have the floor. Be my guest. If you do it, I'm sure a whole lot of people would join you. But right now, I don't see that. If you're out there and that's what you're doing that, then your voice needs to be amplified a little bit more so that others can know and join you. I'm sure they would love to join you. I would love and join you. I'm supporting the HR 40 bill because I don't see any other efforts, widespread efforts that are really pushing and demanding this government to pay us what we owe. And whether you do it on a grassroots level or you do it by the passage of this bill into law, the end result comes from Washington. Those are the people who are going to sign the checks and distribute the reparations owed and due. So I'm here with the HR 40 bill. If there's another organization or a wide nationwide grassroots effort that is willing to challenge this government to finally pay us what's owed and due, I'm with it. I'm with all of that. But like I said, I don't see that. I don't hear that. So since this bill is at the forefront of the nation and has all the attention and all the mouths are talking about, yeah, we owe this, yeah, we should pay that, I'm with it. I'm down to make you, yes, pay that, all that. So that's where I'm at with this HR 40 bill. This is why I created a page, because I recognize that during the last presidential elections, when there were like 20 something candidates, all of them was mouthing reparations. And what they were suggesting was nowhere near reparations. It was the regular ordinary shit that they should be giving us anyway, since we're on the bottom economically. Yes, we need that extra because we've been deprived and denied so long. And even when there is an election, we only get the crumbs. So yeah, we needed that extra, but don't you call it reparations, because that's not what that was. So when I saw that, I'm like, okay, we need to have a page where we can discuss reparations and our people can be made aware of all that is owed to us so that we don't be sold a lie, okay? And that calls itself reparations and it's not reparations. You know, politicians talking about some urban program that they're gonna bring into the Black communities, they be offering that every single election that there is. They're gonna come into your community and they're gonna build houses and the houses are gonna create jobs, yeah, yeah, yeah. Have we progressed? No, we haven't. Okay, so y'all can hold all that for your normal election disbursements and deal with reparations and give us all of what's owed and due. You know, equal the balance of the scales. You know, we're being discriminated by housing, whether you rent or you own a home. I could pull up, I don't know how many videos to show you today, right now, Blacks, well-established Blacks, professional Blacks, own their homes, being defrauded out of the true value of their home. This is today, right now, not 60 years ago. It's still discrimination going on despite all the laws that oppose it. So listen, give us what you owe us and let it do what it do. And for those people that's talking about, oh, don't give Blacks money because they're only going to spend it. Hold on. That is not going to be a reason or a justification for this government to deny what's owed and due us. Okay, you don't get to tell me how to spend my money. It's my money. Give me my money and I do with it what I need to do with it. Just like you do with the money, what the hell you want to do with it, and you give it to who the hell you want to give it to. You know, like banks and corporations take those millions, mess it up, come back. Sorry, we need some more. Okay, how dare you talk about Black folks don't know what to do with their money. Whether we do or not, that is none of your concern. Your issue and your focus should be pay us what you owe us. And that's it. All right, that's all I got to say right now. My page is Cut the Check. This is where we be discussing it. This is where we talk about it. This is where we post any latest update or information that comes out. The main focus also is that this bill, when passed, is going to establish the creation of a commission. That commission has 13 seats on it. And make no mistake about it, far and above anything else, who sits on those seats is going to be the ones who are going to decide how much you get, you know, and how you get it in regards to reparations, okay? Whether it's cash, whether it's land, whether it's no taxes, free tuition, whatever they come up with and say, this is reparations. Those people, those 13 people are going to be the ones to decide. Now, 5 or 6 of those spots are going to be appointed by elected officials. Okay, I believe the president appoints one, the president of the Senate another, et cetera, like that. But there's at least 5 or 6 other seats that are not by appointment by elected officials. And I believe, this is my humble opinion, I believe that the people directly affected or the people who stand to benefit, which is us, should have a say in who sits on those seats. Okay, it should be individuals who know about our suffering, who are historians, who have been dealing with reparations and what they consist of. Those people, such as Dr. Claude Anderson, and there are some others who should sit on those seats. if we sit back and let the power structure decide who sits on the seat, consider yourself robbed already. Okay, because they don't want to give you reparations. I don't care what they say. They not trying to, listen, we being murdered in the street in broad daylight on video by police. You think they trying to give you some money because they enslaved your ancestors? They ain't trying to give you nothing. Okay, let's be clear about that. You're going to have to fight for this. Okay, they're going to use every trick, every reason in the book to not give you reparations. Okay, so please don't think I'm under the impression that all we need to do is pass this law and it's all gravy. No, that's not where I'm coming from. No, not at all. I have this page because I'm stressing to people, you have to become proactive in this. Okay, first of all, y'all don't act like nobody owe you nothing. You know, if John or Jim Bro owed you money, you'd be knocking on his door, sitting out in front of his doorstep, talking about, what's up? Where my money? Okay, but y'all in chill mode. Okay, half of you struggling, can't make it, no way. You know, killing yourself, 2 and 3 jobs, and this government owe you some money, and you know they got it, and they can give it to you. They done paid the banks and corporations. Look at the trillions in COVID. Okay, but you take a pass. You allow yourself to take an L. Oh, they're not going to pay us all that. Why not? You know, where the demand at? Where the fight at? They already acknowledge that they owed it. Okay, this ain't something you got to make them see that they owe us. They already acknowledge the debt is owed. The question is, when you going to pay? It's really that. I ain't trying to complicate this. It's really that simple as far as I'm concerned. But anyway, all right, that's all I got to say right now. I just wanted to clarify the H.R. 40 bill has been voted on to proceed forward. Okay, it came from the Judiciary Committee and they voted to move it forward so that it can have a full vote in the House. Once that vote is passed, it will then go to the Senate, you know, which the Senate is equal. It could go either way. And that's when you're going to see from real ugliness here in America. Okay, because that right there is going to decide if it goes forward, and all hell going to break loose because they're not trying to give you nothing. I don't care what they say. They ain't trying to give you nothing. Okay, but they keep murdering us left and right. You know, maybe they'll be brought to their senses, see, like, you know what? All of this got to stop. You got to come up with something. Okay, because you're not punishing these police. You owe us all this money. You know, you got us living in destitute situations and circumstances. You got to come off of something. You do. Yeah, you do. Anyway, I'm not going there today with this. I just wanted to share this little bit with you for my page, and I hope that clears some of it up. If you're not clear, I don't know, write on the page. But I hope that, you know, do your own research, you know, make your own self aware of this process so you can get in where you fit in and be a part of it. All right. I'm Danette Chavis, and I'll see you on Facebook.